Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
Hello, it's me from Size Sounds in Lewes, Station Street. This is Radio Lewes, where the music matters. I'm not on my own today. I've got my dear mate John with me.
Hello there, Si.
He's come up for a tester, this is, to see if he likes it, and then we can have a new show.
I certainly am.
Yep.
I'm looking around at all the little buttons and dials.
Don't push that one.
I won't touch that one. And I'm thinking, how many of those would I want to touch?
Just don't touch one.
No.
You heard Iggy Pop. And he had somebody playing on that with him, didn't he?
He certainly did. I think he'd have had a Mr. David Bowie.
The great David, which there is quite a bit of a spattering of this in this show.
Yeah, did he play keyboards on that?
Yes, he did, and he sung all the backing vocals, didn't he?
And he did. And he did. I think he also went on tour with him, if I remember right.
77 he did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it was a big surprise to a lot of people when he suddenly turned up unannounced at concerts.
Yep. Clothes and not a dress.
In clothes and not a dress, bless him, which is good. No, so, that was a great...
We've got
track.
A slightly different mix of stuff today.
Mm-hmm.
So, what are you after? What have we got next then?
Well, the next one is Scott Walker, Night Flights. And, okay, we don't want to hammer too much the Bowie connection, but of course, we've got a good version of Night Flights by David Bowie on.
I'm trying to remember
where that is on. It's on Black Tie White Noise.
Of course it is. I knew. I was just testing
you. This is a lovely version. And it's very sad that we no longer have Scott Walker with us.
Yeah, he went a couple of weeks ago now, didn't he?
A couple of weeks.
Yep, and this is Night Flights.
Close on night flights, broken necks and the wings.
Useless information time for you there, John.
Okay.
Yeah, that was from the last Walker Brothers album in 1978.
Excellent stuff.
I cheated because I looked it up on the net.
Which I'm sure I'll do plenty of that myself. That's really great. No, but it's a good album.
It's really interesting, isn't it? He was one of the only other people that I think was interesting.
I agree with you.
Bowie, you know, sort of, you never knew what you were going to get.
But I got myself confused with the Walker Brothers because the Walker Brothers were not actually the Walker Brothers. Am I right in thinking that?
Yeah, Scott Walker was the Walker.
Yeah, and who was the other guy?
His brother.
I know. No. This is rotten of me, just giving you all these quiz
Gary
questions.
Walker.
Gary Walker.
You say was his brother.
He was.
Yeah. You're thinking of the Righteous Brothers.
You see, this is the problem with getting old. All start to blend into one. I thought the Walker Brothers actually was just a name. I didn't realise that was actually the name.
No, of the brothers they were brothers. It says here, black and white.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Okay. No.
Fair enough. That's fair enough.
What do we have on the next on the fine list, sir?
Well, next we have See Emily Play. This is from David Bowie's 1973 Pin-Ups album, as opposed to the original Pink Floyd.
Pink Floyd from... Yeah. It was a single, wasn't it?
Yeah. I think this actually, personally, I think this and Sorrow are the two most successful tracks on Pin-Up.
And I think this is the better version.
Won't go as far as to say that, sorry.
Personal opinion. Here we go.
Tomorrow.
If anybody knows that bit of classical music at the end of that track, can you email in to Radio Lewes for us? Because we don't know what it is, and we want to know.
Yep, certainly do.
So in maybe fact, either Philippa could tell us.
I think she may.
You never know.
I think there's actually possibly one or two in there, actually, Si.
There you go. See, now then mix and matching, you see, this is good.
Okay.
Right, what have we got next, then?
Okay, well, next we move to... We're moving very seamlessly along here. It's Lucifer Sam from the Piper at the Gates of Dawn Pink Floyd album. Now, we still have got Sid Barrett with us now, haven't we?
Yeah. No, Sid's gone.
Has he gone,
Bob? Yes. Yeah, Sid was... Yeah, sorry. I thought you meant now. Yeah,
No.
He was still... Sid was still there.
He was still there, but... He was, would have been very much towards the very end. For
he
him,
was yeah. there, his body was there, but his head weren't.
Bless him, no.
There's a good quote that they said he took a trip and never came back.
It's kind of sad, though, actually.
Yeah.
It is.
It's Lucifer Sam. I think that was a mono version as well.
It was it now.
Yeah.
You're very pedantic. It's definitely a mono version, was it? Yeah. Oh, I realise that now. Yeah, thank you, Simon.
That's all right. I'll sit back in the corner now.
Okay.
Oh, dear.
No, that was good. So, where should we go next?
Oh, I think we're changing direction slightly, isn't it?
And we're certainly changing time period too, because now we've moved right up to the late 1990s.
It's pulp, isn't it?
It is pulp. It's hardcore. This is the first track called The Fear.
Very Bowie-esque vocal.
It's very Bowie-esque, and it's also got a little... This is going to be useless. There's also a little tagline with it, which is saying it's the horror of... It's on the album. The horror of suburbia or something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I vaguely remember. It'll be in the... It's in there.
It's a really sort of quite... a rather difficult track, but I love it.
It's a great track.
I love it.
We'll be right back.
I do like an ending like that, oh, with the guitars go boop, boop.
That is full of angst.
Yes. Shall I read you the little bit that it said about it?
Yes, please read us a little bit.
This is our music from The Bachelor's Den. The sound of loneliness turned up to 10. A horror soundtrack from a stagnant waterbed, and it sounds just like this.
There you are. So
he weren't happy when he did that, was he?
He was not happy at all. He really was not happy.
He wasn't a happy
But it's a smashing track.
It's
it
great,
really
isn't
it? Is smashing.
Turn it up loud if you didn't. Go back and play it really loud.
Okay. Right. Anecdote time.
Right. Oh.
Yeah, it's only a little anecdote. Oh, you sounded like... I can't remember who you sounded like there, but you did sound like someone. There you are. Broken English, Marianne Faithfull.
Yep.
From the album Broken English. And came out in 1979, and I was actually I got a lift home when you used to do hitchhiking from somebody.
hitchhiking.
That's how it was back in those days. I was going back towards Eastbourne, and they put on. I think it would have been a tape back then. It was a tape of Marianne Faithfull, and it was this particular album. And the last I had heard of Marianne Faithfull was sort of the 60s. Early 70s, and I thought of her as a little sweet songstress singing Little Bird and things like that, and a lot of the early covers that she did, like the Rolling Stones things. And I was absolutely stunned to hear this voice, this sort of cracked, pained voice, turning out this incredible song. And I did genuinely say to the person I was with, "Who on earth is this?" And they said, "It's Marianne Faithfull." Now, that doesn't seem a shock now, because a lot of us are used to that's how she sounds. But back then, it was a heck of a shock that she should sound like that. But it's a marvellous track and a marvellous album. Broken English, Marianne Faithfull.
Thank you.
just suddenly disappeared then.
That hen vaded out a bit quicker.
Yeah, we were just nattering away.
We were.
About our next track, wasn't it? It's the Kinks.
It is.
It's Brainwashed from the Arthur album, which I was just about to say to you that they were well out of favour when this was recorded.
In what ways?
The public had lost interest in them. They'd done Village Green Preservation Society, which didn't sell at all at the time, but now's a classic, apparently. And this was the follow-up to that, and it was the Arthur concept album about a guy moving to Australia. So this is Brainwashed.
That was
Brainwashed. That's been covered by lots of bands, sort of garage rock bands in America.
Oh, really?
Yeah, covered that. I've got it by the G.J. Cobras, which I played on this show many a time.
Oh, excellent.
So there you go. Useless information for you there.
See,
we're throwing at each other now.
Well, there you are. Now, some more useless information for the next track, because it's the Sensational Alex Harvey Band, who I love. Actually saw a Sensational Alex Harvey Band twice. Once by default, I was at Reading Festival. 1973,
right.
I think would be right for that. And then I saw them on tour down at what was the Top Rank.
Yeah, Top Rank Suite.
Top Rank Suite, and they were brilliant. The only thing to say about the 1973 at Reading that I remember was they came on about fifth on the bill. Forgive me if I'm wrong with that, but it was about fifth on the bill. And they absolutely wiped the floor with everything to follow. And whatever came on afterwards, you were just thinking, I wish it was...
Put Alex Harvey back
on. Yeah, it was something they became quite well known for doing, actually. Superb to see live. Really well.
The other bad thing about that gig was the beer was warm.
Indeed.
Should we play Alex Harvey?
We will.
Everybody shakes my hand. can call me the soft shoe banana. You can peel away my skin.
And I knew
push this like this, we can talk over him going sha-la-la-la.
Oh, that's lovely.
It's great, isn't it? We could join in then.
What a change in pace for Alex there at the
end. I like that one. As we were saying, all the punks and that loved Alex Harvey as well.
Yeah, and you can see why.
Yeah, because he didn't fit in anywhere.
No. No.
Sensational, that Alex Harvey band they were.
Certainly
was. See what I did there, mate?
Certainly did. Alex Harvey, you would be pleased to have it.
Yes. What are we going to play now, then?
Well, next we'll move to the final track on Hunky Dory, which is the Bewley Brothers by David Bowie. This is a bit of a special track.
Like this track. Listen, I snuck this on there.
And he did do it live once. Am I right in thinking that was on the Jonathan Ross show?
Jonathan Ross, yes.
And he actually did quite a good job with it. Apart from the little, as he said, gnomic effects at the end. But it's a really impenetrable but fabulous track.
Turn it up loud.
And so the story goes, they wore the clothes, they said the things to make it seem improbable. The will of a lie like the hope it was. And the good men tomorrow had their feet in the wallow, and their heads of brawn were nice ashorn, and how they bought their positions with saccharine and trust. And the world was asleep to our latent fuss. Sang the swell through the streets like the crust of the sun, the Bewley Brothers. In our wings that bark, flashing teeth of brass, standing tall in the dark. So he could scream and still relax. Unbelievable. And we frightened the small children away. And our talk was old, and dust would flow through our veins. And lo, it was midnight back at the kitchen door, like the grim face on the cathedral floor. The solid book we wrote cannot be found today. And it was stalking time for the moon boys, the Bewley Brothers.
With our backs on the arch, and if the devil may be here, but we can't sing about that. We were so turned on. You thought we were bacon.
And now the dress is hung, the ticket pawned, the Factor Max that proved the fact is melted down, woven on the edging of my pillow. And my brother lays upon the rocks. He could be dead, he could be not, he could be you. He's chameleon, comedian, Corinthian and caricature. Shooting up high in the sky, Bewley Brothers. In the feeble in the bad, Bewley Brothers. Hungry dark was where we played our mark. Oh, we were gone, kings of oblivion. We were so turned on in the night of pavilion.
please and take me by. I'm starving for me gravy. Leave my shoes and door unlocked, I might just slip away. Hey, just for the day. Hey, please come away. Hey, just for the day. Please come away. Please come away. Just for the day. Please come away. Please come away.
I've always wanted to be in a David Bowie record. Should we talk over it? Yeah.
This is the only bit. I, if you got me singing, this is the only bit I could be allowed to join in.
Oh, that'd be hilarious.
I could sing this. I actually did try once to sing and had it recorded. And it exists as a tape somewhere.
Oh, we could play that one. Yeah. Whoever's got that, just...
It is worth hearing. Terrible. I predated punk by 20 years, I tell you.
I'm keeping the dream alive now.
That was good, that track. Love that.
That was from my favourite Bowie album, Hunky Dory.
Superb. 1971.
Oh, there I was just go. A little wee nipper then.
You were indeed.
Yes, I was.
Now, also in 1971, yeah?
Yep.
We have Electric Warrior album.
See, it's another one of my favourite albums. How did them tracks get on there is beyond me. I don't know.
And that's Life's a Gas. Now, this is down as Mark Bolan and T-Rex. So was it T-Rex?
It was T-Rex, yeah.
It was T-Rex.
Yeah, it was T-Rex. And there's a nice bit of footage on the Cilla Black show of him singing this. And Cilla Black singing it and singing it really well.
Really?
Yeah, honestly, you want to Google it. It's good. But this has been played many a time on this show, but I'm going to play it again because I really like it.
Great.
I've loved you good like a planet. I could have changed your heart to a star. But it all really doesn't matter at all. No, it all really doesn't matter at all. Life's a gas. I could have built a house on the ocean. I could have placed our love in the sky. But it all really doesn't matter at all. No, it all really doesn't matter at all. Life's a gas. I could have turned you into a priestess. I could have burned your feet in the sand. But it all really doesn't matter at all. No, it all really doesn't matter at all. Life's a gas. Life's a gas. I hope it's gonna last. But it all really doesn't matter at all. No, it all really doesn't matter at all. Life's a gas.
Busy nattering again, and the track just faded out.
It ended.
Electric Warrior from 1971-72.
Yeah, Tony Visconti, you
said. Visconti, yeah, produced it. It's a brilliant album.
It's really good, yeah. And I do remember when it actually came out, that was such a commercially popular album too.
Yeah.
It really was.
And it had a huge poster with it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Which would have been with the guitar?
It's one of him. He's on a beanbag.
Really?
Yeah, it's like he can't get off the beanbag. He's like, oh, no. But, yeah.
There we are. Yeah. And finally, a little anecdote on that. I can remember the crowds around the dome. You see what an old man I am.
Yeah.
You can remember the crowds around the
I'll help you on the bus when we leave.
Thank you. I have got my pass with me.
Oh, cool. So can I use it?
You can. Very shortly, Simon. You
very shortly,
can.
Really, yeah.
Oh, perhaps we ought to move to the next track then. Well, I've got the little list here. I've got Sid Barrett from the Madcap Laughs. Now, this is a bonus track called No Good Trying.
Yeah.
Not included, obviously, on the original album.
So a lot of the Sid Barrett stuff, there'd be different titles for them. They'd be the same song, but different titles.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it is on the album,
but
under a different title. And this album's bonkers.
Well, I enjoy Sid Barrett now. That's your education to me on Sid Barrett.
My Sarah goes, what's that rubbish? Because it is very childlike and sort of out of tune and but interesting. So this is Sid Barrett.
It's no good trying to place your hand where I can't see, because I understand that you're different from me. Yes, I can tell that you can't be what you pretend, and you're rocking backwards and you're rocking towards the red and yellow mane of a stallion horse.
Never heard any Sid Barrett, go and listen to the Madcap Laughs album, because it is all really good. It's interesting stuff. May I've told you.
There you go. And now I know. Well, that hour's gone.
It's gone. It? Thank you. This has been Si from Si Sounds and my dear friend John, who will be doing Radio Lewes shows regularly.
I will.
Regularly.
I'm still trying to think of a title.
No, I've got a few.
Okay.
Rambling John.
Oh, dear.
It'd be like Jack Hargreaves out of town.
Oh, there's a thought.
Yeah, thank you very much for coming in, John.
Thank you so much for having me.
And we'll be doing, like I say, we're going to be doing a lot more What are we going to finish with?
We're going to finish with Tomorrow Never Knows. This is from the Beatles, and I do see it does say mono CD. Oh,
of course it's the mono. There is a difference. I've played them back to back. I'm being really sad. I did play the stereo version and then the mono, and there is something about the mono. You hear more...
Stronger.
Yeah, you hear more about it. Mm. It's really interesting. So it's, they're a band, they're a one-hit wonder. They won't make any more records.
No, that'll be about it.
So sorry to finish on a no-hopers. It's the Beatles. Till next time, bye-bye.
Bye.
For a worldwide audience.